We already know that Cardano is into development phases. We also know that ecosystem is not that vibrant. Not many developers are developing on Cardano. The TVL is very bad, but still people are investing in Cardano. People are very bullish about Cardano and its native token, ADA. Why? Let me tell you why. Hey guys, this is your host Hitesh Malviya and welcome once again to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I will discuss the fundamental analysis of Cardano, the tractions of Cardano so far and its future roadmap, and whether you should invest or not, also the risk associated with this particular investment. So make sure you watch this video till the end and make sure you also subscribe my YouTube channel so you don't miss out updates and also the future videos I am going to create on different cryptocurrency covering their fundamental analysis. So also click on the bell icon so don't miss any update. So let's start with Cardano. It is impossible to have a blockchain network which is having a greater decentralization, a greater security, and a greater scalability. No one has achieved it. Right? If you talk about Bitcoin, Bitcoin has greater security, greater decentralization, but Bitcoin is not scalable, right? So that was blockchain 1.0. If you talk about Ethereum, which is referred as blockchain 2.0, so Ethereum has a greater security. Ethereum has a good decentralization, but they are compromising very big on scalability part. So the scalability part is not been achieved so far. The current pool of blockchain networks, whether it is layer 1 or layer 2, are not that scalable, right? If they wanted to build a decentralized financial network or a payment network, they need to process at least like Visa or maybe more scalable than Visa. And that is the race of all the blockchain networks are currently in right now, whether it is Solana or Ethereum is coming up with Ethereum 2.0. They wanted to achieve a greater security, they wanted to achieve the greater scalability, and also they wanted to achieve the greater decentralization. And that is also the objective of Cardano. So there is nothing different here. All these different layer one blockchains, which we have today, whether it is Solana, Avalanche, they are trying to achieve the same things. They are trying to solve the blockchain dilemma problem. So blockchain dilemma problem is the key here. They wanted to crack this. And Cardano is using scientific approach to reach the greater level of security, decentralization, and scalability. Cardano is a peer-to-peer reviewed using scientific approach to launch their codes and launch their product features to and build their blockchain networks. And their code is being reviewed by academicians from different top universities. And that is why their development process is very slow. Their development process is being divided into 5 phases. Currently, they are into the third phase. Their third phase will be over soon. And then they will enter into the fourth phase, which is for scaling the blockchain network, and the final phase will be to provide the governance on their blockchain network. So it will take some time from here to reach the final stage, maybe like 1 or 2 years, right? Because their development is very slow, and also at the same time it is delayed at multiple times, and they are also doing a couple of hard forks to improve the existing system at the same time. There are three different entities which are looking after Cardano project. The first entity is Cardano Foundation, which is a non-profit organization registered in Switzerland. And the second organization is IOG, which used to be known as IOHK. IOG is like Input-Output Global. And Input-Output Global is looking after the development of the Cardano blockchain network. And we have Imargo. So Imargo is a body which is looking after corporate relationships, corporate partnerships, government partnerships, and also educational partnership of Cardano to spread the adoption of Cardano. They are working on different branding and marketing exercise for the Cardano project. Cardano was founded by Charles Hoskinson and Jeremy Wood. Charles Hoskinson was one of the 8 co-founders of Ethereum. And he joined Vitalik in Ethereum project back in 2014 when he was developing Ethereum. And Vitalik and Charles Hoskinson had dispute over the commercial direction for the Ethereum. And Vitalik was in favor of being a non-profit entity, But Charles Hoskinson was looking for a commercial direction. He wanted Ethereum to become a profit organization or a listed company or something. So they had ideological difference. That's why Charles Hoskinson left with Jeremy Wood. Jeremy Wood was also working with Ethereum Foundation at that time. And these two guys, they left the company and they started working on another project, which they named Cardano. And they started working on Cardano in 2015. And they launched Cardano in 2017 when they listed on one of the cryptocurrency exchanges, Bittrex, and they launched ADA at the time. And ADA was like 100x up from the seed price. A seed sale was happened back in 2015 for a very limited set of people, mostly from Japan. So the total supply of ADA is somewhere around 45 billion. And the circulating supply is somewhere around 33.5 billion. And they have an annual reward rate of 4 to 5%. 21% of supply is being reserved by Cardano Foundation. And that supply is being used for reward distribution for those guys who are staking ADA. And also this supply will be released to the public slowly but gradually. And by the end of 2050, 99% of the supply of ADA will be released in circulation. If you look at the supply distribution, you will find 98% of the supply is being distributed among retail investors, right? That makes ADA one of the most decentralized cryptocurrency in the coin market right now. If you compare it with Solana, you will find like whales are holding more than 50 to 60% supply of Solana. Same with Matic, same with Avalanche. But here, this is one of the major difference here. That is also retail investors are very bullish about ADA because retail investors are heavily invested in ADA and they are also controlling the 98% of the circulating supply together, which is very bullish. If you talk about the opportunities wise, Africa is a very big opportunities for companies who wanted to build blockchain related solutions, who wanted to democratize the governance in different countries and who wanted to create decentralized system for government. So I believe Africa is a big playground here, not only for Cardano, but also for Ethereum and other layer one blockchain network and also layer two blockchain network. So here Cardano has a lead because they already have partnered with one of the nation in Africa and they are also in talk with different nations in Africa. So if things works with that identity project which they name Atala Prism, if that works well, it got traction in the near time, other countries also can follow, not only the African countries but also the Latin American countries and also the third world countries. There's a scope of improvement in underdeveloped countries. They wanted to improve, right? They wanted to improve their structure. They wanted to improve their governance. And this is the opportunity for them. So Cardano is trying to be the leader in that space and they're trying to work closely with all these governments, whether it is Zanzibar and whether it is, you know, Ethiopia or maybe like some other countries, they are in talk right now. So they can leverage this opportunity, in my opinion, because they already sense this opportunity. They already started working in that direction. So that is one of the major traction here. If you ask about the validated nodes of Cardano, so on that front, they are way ahead from Solana. Solana is currently having almost 1,850 validated nodes in the network who are validating the transactions. Cardano is having 2000 plus validators in the network without having a vibrant ecosystem. That is a huge deal. Like that, not many projects are building on Cardano right now, but still the validator count is more than the projects they are having in their ecosystem. That is a very positive sign. The more validators will improve the security of the protocol. And on that front, Cardano is more secure than Solana. So if you talk about the ecosystem wise tractions, so right now 1000 plus projects are building on Cardano ecosystem and 40% of them are NFT collections. 1% out of them may be a good projects, but I think most of these NFT projects are just a cash grab here. So there is no value over there. So I believe only 500 plus projects are valuable in the ecosystem. So ecosystem is very young in my opinion. So there is no much traction on ecosystem side right now. So I think they might get some more onboarding of developers, and when developers will find the usefulness of Cardano blockchain, they will move to Cardano. But there is a tough competition out there. So we need to watch and see what will happen in the near future. But right now the ecosystem is not that vibrant. The development ecosystem is not that vibrant. And also if you talk about the TVL, total value locked, right? The total value locked in the network is somewhere around $300 billion, which is very low, right? So like Ethereum is having a value locked over $40 billion. Solana is also having like $7 to $8 billion of value locked in the network. So that traction is very low in my opinion. But on the community side, that Cardano is having one of the most vibrant community out there. They have 700,000 people on Reddit, and they have more than 1 million people on social media talking about Cardano. In short, they are having 3 million people who are supporting Cardano, right? Whether it is investor or their academians or community members or developers, different sort of people. Also, at the same time, 71% of ADA is currently staked right now, which is a good ratio. We already know that Cardano is into development phases. We also know that ecosystem is not that vibrant. Not many developers are developing on Cardano. The TVL is very bad. But still people are investing in Cardano. People are very bullish about Cardano and its native token, ADA. Why? Let me tell you why. Because of Charles Hoskinson, because of the founder himself, because of his personality. He's having a very charismatic personality. The way he addresses his vision to his community member, the way he connects, the way he goes on live call with his community members almost every weekend, that is what is, you know, putting that trust in the community. That is why the community is backing him and backing his vision and loving Cardano as a project. I believe winning the trust of community, a global community from all around the world, is not an easy task. But he has done that, and the community is one of the major traction they have achieved in my opinion. And because of the community vibes, I think community will keep driving the value of Cardano in the near future as long they are developing. Because it's currently in development phase, so we never know, they might do something great in the near future, because currently as they're saying, they are also observing market failures. They are learning from mistakes done by some other layer one projects, and they are trying to become a better network which can have a major scalability and, you know, which can achieve a greater security, at the same time greater decentralization and the governance. And also at the same time, they are also working with different governments. So they have some advantage here and there, but the main advantage here is the community. And the vibes of community and the way community is promoting this project, which is very bullish. So if you talk about the risk associated with ADA, so I would say the risk is the market failure here. Because right now they are already slow in development approach. And even they are saying that they will only launch when they will be ready, that the things will work properly. But still they have faced some failure in couple of their recent updates. And at the same time, it's a very competitive market. A lot of layer one blockchain networks are developing, and they are developing very fast. Like Solana, Avalanche, new projects are coming like Sui, Celestia, new concepts are coming like JK Rollups. It's an innovating industry. A lot of different projects are innovating, right? So the slow approach may kill Cardano if they fail to achieve what they wanted to achieve in the near future. That is one of the biggest risk here. Now let's talk about the price prediction here. So the market cap is almost very high in my opinion. Like $14.5 billion is too much at this price point. You cannot win against community, and if the community is very strong like Shiba Coin and Dogecoin, they had no utility, but still they managed to become top 10 cryptocurrency, right? But at least Cardano has a utility, Cardano has a vibrant ecosystem, Cardano is building on different projects. They are also working with different governments, they have a vision, they have a technology, and they have a greater community like Dogecoin and Shiba Coin. So if you consider that, then and we might see Cardano to reach above like 60 to 70 billion dollar market cap by next bull cycle. So 10x is possible in my opinion. So if you are buying Cardano below $0.5, I think the price can reach $5 in next 3 to 5 years. But you need to hold it for long terms. You need to become a diamond holders like all the community members of Cardano. And you need to hold it tight for next 3 to 5 years. Then you can reach to that gains in the near future. But at the same time, they will keep on having short-term updates. Like they will have a couple of hard forks in the near future because the development is still going on. So you will keep seeing these short-term rallies, in my opinion. So whenever you see the dip and whenever you see there's some major update is coming from Cardano Foundation, you can also look for short-term trades in that case. So like right now, they are approaching for another hard fork, which is Vashil hard fork, to reduce the cost of large transaction. Then they will also work on different improvement proposals. It is not that major updates, but it is also one of the updates. So a lot of people are buying because of that updates. And this is not a financial advice. I am not holding ADA right now. And I'm also not advising you to buy ADA. This is your call and you can do your own research. You can also do your secondary research. Use this information for your education only. So that is all from my side. So I hope you like this video. And if you like the fundamental analysis on Cardano, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe my YouTube channel and click on bell icon so you don't miss any updates in the near future. Thank you.